Today, we are going to discuss about Muhammad bin Tughlaq, who is known in the Indian history for his experiments. One such experiment was shifting the capital of his empire from Delhi to Devgiri or Daulatabad. In 1327, Muhammad bin Tughlaq passed an order to move his capital from Delhi to Daulatabad in present-day Maharashtra in the Deccan region of India. Muhammad bin Tughlaq said that it would help him to establish control over the fertile land of the Deccan region. As the Deccan was very far from Delhi and he wanted to strengthen his control over the Deccan, he decided to shift his capital to south. It was not always possible to operate army from Delhi for the occupation of southern states. Secondly, as his empire grew more in south, he wanted to create a capital more central to his empire. He chose Daulatabad, which was approximately equidistant from both the northern and southern extremes of his empire. He also felt that it would make him safe from the Mongol invasions, which were mainly aimed at Delhi and regions in North India. Daulatabad appeared to be at a safe distance from the possible Mongol attacks in the future. But Ibn Battuta, on the other hand, gives a completely different reason for this transfer of capital. According to him, Sultan Muhammad bin Tughlaq was disgusted with the life of Delhi because he was getting almost daily many anonymous letters from the people of the city abusing and criticizing him, and therefore he wanted to leave it for good. It is believed that the general public of Delhi was not in favor of shifting the base to Daulatabad. This seems to have annoyed Tughlaq, for he ordered all people of Delhi to proceed to Daulatabad with their belongings. Ibn Battuta cites that the force was applied without any leniency. Ziauddin Barni mentions, without consultation or weighing the pros and cons, he brought ruin on Delhi, which for 170 to 180 years had grown in prosperity and rivaled Baghdad and Cairo. The city with its sarais and suburbs and villages spread over 4 or 5 leagues, all was destroyed, that is, deserted. Not a cat or a dog was left. Though, probably it was just an exaggeration. In fact, some historians believe that Daulatabad was just a second capital or administrative center, and Delhi remained the first administrative center or capital. Though major arrangements were made for this shifting of capital and migration of people, there was resentment among the people as they did not want to shift from Delhi. This 1500 kilometer journey was arduous. Many people died on the way due to hunger and exhaustion, and the survivors were not able to adjust to the new conditions. And there were many others who felt homesick as they missed their age-old homeland. But Muhammad bin Tughlaq could not keep his decision for long. Fearing that the Sultanate's northern borders were exposed to attacks, in 1335 he decided to shift the capital back to Delhi, allowing the citizens to return to their previous city. Muhammad bin Tughlaq realized the fact that just as he could not control south from Delhi, in the same way he could not control north from Daulatabad. The entire process or experiment was surely not a pleasant experience. It involved a huge financial loss and grave consequences for Delhi. Not only had the imperial city lost many of its people, it had also lost its former prosperity and grandeur. The widespread public resentment against the Sultan also led to revolts and bitterness that rankled the Sultanate for years to come. Though Tughlaq invited many scholars and artists to settle in the city, the impact of this incident had far-reaching consequences. Ibn Battuta The famous traveler who came to Delhi in 1334 during Tughlaq's reign wrote in his memoirs that he found certain parts of the city still deserted. Though the attempt to make Devgiri or Daulatabad the capital failed to a large extent, it had a number of long-range benefits. It helped in bringing north and south closer by improving communications. Many people, including religious divines who had gone to Daulatabad, settled down there. They became the means of spreading in the Deccan the cultural, religious, and social ideas which the Turks had brought with them to North India. This resulted in a new process of cultural interaction between North and South India. I hope you like this video. For more such academic videos, do not forget to subscribe this YouTube channel, Constructing Minds.